We remember that in the very beginning, God saw that it was not good for a man to be alone. So he made a helpmate, a partner for him, suitable for him, and established this institution of marriage while the heavenly host witnessed this wonderful scene. I say this to say not just to Brian and Hannah, but to all of us that originated in divine wisdom and goodness. That's what marriage is. And it's designed to promote human happiness and holiness. And marriage is the very foundation of home life and social order. And so it will be, I believe, to the very end of time. Therefore, marriage should not be entered into thoughtlessly, but advisedly, thinking and being in the fear of God. That is the purpose for which God authored it, ordained it, and blessed it. And folks, there are so many occasions that we can look into the scripture and we can find. When Jesus was invited with his disciples to a marriage feast at Cana of Galilee, he gladly accepted because it was a celebration. It was a time of goodness and honor, a wondrous time. And of course, we know that it was at this particular celebration of a marriage feast that Jesus began his public ministry and all of his mighty acts of power, where he changed the water into wine because his mother wanted him to do this. So we're assembled here as witnesses to this ceremony and also assembled before God to listen to the vows that Brian and Hannah will recite and repeat to each other. So as we witness the things that they're going to say to each other, and then we're going to send them away with our blessings and our wishes for our great and wonderful wife. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Thank you. From the scripture, we read these words. From the very